got to stand together. Father God, we thank you for our goodness. We thank you, Lord, that today we celebrate Mothering Sunday and all things about being a mother, being a mother figure, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you hold us in your hands and you keep us safe, Lord Jesus. Please bless us today and touch our hearts and minds as we worship together. Amen. Thank you, Naomi.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. What better way to bless the Lord on Mothering Sunday?
just going to come into a time of prayer. I haven't been given any prayer requests, but that's okay because God knows what's on our hearts and what's on our minds. So let's pray together. Father God, we thank you, Lord, that you are the God of everything, Lord, that you can work where we are. You can be in church with us today, you can be at home as we watch it on the screen, and you can be with us while we're at work or at school, Lord. And Father God, we just pray that whatever we come to this week, that you put your hand upon us and that you will know, Lord, that you're there with us, that you're guiding us through each and every day, Father God. And we pray, Lord Jesus, for the situation in Ukraine, Lord, and we just pray that, Lord Jesus, put peace in our hearts as we watch what's going on, Lord, on the TV. Put our thoughts in our minds to pray for these people, Lord, who are suffering. But we thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are the God over all, no matter where we are and what we are doing. We thank you, Lord. Amen. Jim, you can bring the notices.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning.
We're the remnant that hasn't caught COVID, which is good. So good to see everyone. I think there's so many off of the moment, but it's good. But guys, a couple of just quick announcements. First of all, can we just say thank you to all those who've stepped in? We give a big clap today. We didn't say this. Susie and Jacqueline, especially, they came before the service and they went, well, this person can't make it today. This person can't make it. They've done a cracking job and Jackson stepped in last minute. Michelle's watching at home. She's hopefully nearly there. We miss you, Michelle. Come on back in. So, a couple of announcements. First one is this. We're raising Easter eggs for our Easter celebration. So if you want to find out what's going on, it's just on our website. You just do a /, at the end of the website. Stuff's going to make available what's happening at Easter from tomorrow. But we're still after a few more Easter eggs. So if you're able to buy some medium-sized Easter eggs, that'll be absolutely brilliant. We've currently got hundreds of Easter eggs, okay, in my office. I'm really going to try not to eat them, okay, this week, the best of my ability. But we're going to do some egg hunts for free community eggs, egg hunts. A lot of the time with egg hunts, if you go to the community, they're about £2 or £3 each, okay, for kids to go along to. And so imagine that you're a family, you've got 2 or 3 kids, adds up very quickly, doesn't it? And so what we're going to do is we want to do a couple of these hunts that are free for kids just to come along and enjoy, especially at a time when there's a bit of when the crunch is really hitting people. So if you can afford to buy a £1 egg, 2 £1 eggs, or if you want to give us a little bit, we can buy them for you. That's no problem. Then I've extended the date till next week. And we also want to send all the kids home in the local village schools with an egg. The next thing is part of our Easter weekend celebrations, we're going to do some baptisms. So if you haven't been baptized, come and have a chat with me. And we're going to do, me and Pastor Ravine are going to do a baptismal class. We have a few people who already spoke to us. But if you'd like to be baptized, come and let me know. And the final announcement is this, that next weekend, we have our weekend of prayer. Has anyone signed up for a slot yet? A few of you have. If you haven't, sign up for a slot. It's really easy to do. It'll be on the email tomorrow morning that goes out to book a place for church. And every weekend we've done this weekend of prayer, we've seen people start coming to church for the first time. We've seen answers to prayer. It's been amazing what God has done. So I want to encourage you just to get along to it. If you go online, cornerstoneelamchurch.co.uk/prayer, okay, you can find the sign up links there. And also you can find out the different prayer events that are happening over the weekend. Back over to you.
Brilliant. Lots going on, isn't there? Oh, gosh. Take it off. That's better. Wow, what a special day it is today to all the mums and those who mother people as well. But please, if you're a man, please don't leave now, because there's something for everybody today, and we're going to be talking about the big family of God. So you're all so welcome today. And we hope that you'll be blessed and encouraged and really meet with God as well. We've got lots going on, and I just want to say a big thank you as well. Reiterate what Jim said. Thank you to all those taking part, because it's a real encouragement. In a minute, the Big Fish children, they're going to sing a song about us all belonging to the family of God. But first, we're going to read from God's Word, from Romans chapter 12, verses 9 to 13. And I'm hoping, I don't know if they're going to come on the screen. No, they're not going to come on the screen. Well, I was going to get you all to join in, because I like a bit of congregation participation, but you'll have to listen to me instead. Right, Romans 12, starting at verse 9. Your love must be real. Hate what is evil. Hold on to what is good. Love each other like brothers and sisters. Give your brothers and sisters more honour than you want for yourselves. Do not be lazy, but work hard. Serve the Lord with all your heart. Be joyful because you have hope. That's wonderful, isn't it? Especially in today's world. Be patient when trouble comes. We all need to know that. And pray at all times. Share with God's people who need help. Bring strangers in need into your homes. And that really just made me think about all that's going on with the Ukrainian refugees coming over, you know, and people opening up their homes. I'm going to talk a bit more about that later. But without further ado, Big Fish children, please come and join me, because I don't want to sing on my own. Please. Oh dear. Anybody? Big Fish children, I'd really love it. Even if you just do the actions, you're allowed to point in this song. Something you're not allowed to do anywhere else, pointing. Come on, that's it. Brilliant, Poppy and Bethany. Anybody else? Any more Big Fish? No, well, here we go. We've got the cream. Come and stand over here. And Little Fish, actually, can you come up? And Hannah's got some things that you're going to wave, Little Fish. Any Little Fish like to come? Oh, come on, yes. Brilliant. Come and join us. Fantastic. I wonder if there's any Big Fish leaders that could sit at the front as well and do some actions. Ooh. Or not. Fantastic. Oh, brilliant. Pip's come as well. Here we go. Oh, and Zachary. Come on, Zachary. Oh, that's brilliant, that is. Have a look. They've been making some fantastic things in Little Fish for their mums. They've made some daffodils. And they're going to wave them. Right, this song is called Big Family of God. I'm hoping we've got that. Here we go. Join in if you want to as well.
You know.
Wow, wasn't that fantastic? Brilliant. Thank you very much, Big Fish and Little Fish. That was wonderful. Oh, I think that's my favourite part of the service. Wow. Right, we've got a video next, but I'd like to ask Eve to come up, please. And Eve, yes, Eve to come up. And we're going to have a video, and Eve and I are going to read something to go with it, all about mothers. And just like that song said, we're all part of the family of God. This is about different mums from the Bible. And it just shows you that it's not all about just birth mothers, it's about lots of different mothers. Okay. Motherhood plays an important role in the Bible. It binds the beginning and the end. These stories offer us a glimpse into the heart of God, and so we will start at the beginning. Taken from the side of Adam, gifted with bringing forth life, the first woman was named Eve, and she was the mother of all living, but she was also a mother in her own right, the first of many mothers to come.
I'm going to talk about Sarah, the promised mother. Though Sarah's womb was closed, God promised nations and kings would come from her. 10 years passed, and motherhood seems as impossible as the day it was promised. But the Lord is faithful to keep his promises, and Sarah bore a son who made her laugh. Then we have got Leah, the forgotten mother. Leah was the firstborn, overlooked by her husband, Jacob, who gave his heart to her young sister. When the Lord saw that Leah was hated, he opened her womb. Despite Jacob's disdain, she found her motherhood in the Lord. Then we go to Jochebed, the sacrificial mother. When Pharaoh became angry at the fruitfulness of the Hebrews, Jochebed sacrificed his motherhood for the sake of her son. When Pharaoh's daughter saw the child, she had compassion on him. Because of Jochebed's sacrificial motherhood, the Israelites found freedom. Naomi, the spiritual mother. Naomi was a mother who experienced the loss of her sons. Yet she gained daughter in Ruth, who declared, "Where you go, I will go. Your people will be my people. Your God, my God." Naomi and Ruth became family by faith. We have got Mary. Mary, a virgin and not yet married, was found to be with the child by the Holy Spirit. The motherhood of this blessed woman was more than the continuation of a family name, but it meaning for God to bring a savior into the world to save his people from their sins.
From the garden to the cross, there have always been mothers. These women paved the way for all women, representing the full spectrum of the ways one can be called mum. Whether a mother in faith, mentorship, adoption, or by birth, all ladies play an important role in the stories of generations to come. To all the Sarahs, Leahs, Jochebeds, and Naomis, happy Mother's Day. Okay, I'm going to ask Chloe to come and join us now. Please. She's going to be talking about our church family here and how the church family has helped her.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Here we go.
My mum is lovely. She is kind, caring and loving to me. She drives me to different places when she can, which I really can't thank you enough, Mum. I love you. My cousin Jeanette is like a mum to me as well, because she helps me, looks after me, and she's a great cousin. I would also like to say is that my nan and auntie Sonia are amazing and look out for me. Thank you. Mother's Day is more because we have a great big church family of ladies who look out for each other and take care of each other like mothers to each other. Last thing I would like to say is our lovely friend Anne-Marie, our friendship has grown and is growing still. Me, Michelle, Jeanette and Anne-Marie are reading the Bible each day on our Bible apps as a group, which is interesting. It's lovely that Anne-Marie comes along to Luncheon Club, Friendly Hour and the Friday Cafe too. Thank you to all the other amazing women in my life, family and friends. God bless. Happy Mother's Day.
Oh, thank you, Chloe. Yeah, give her a clap. I don't know how much it takes to come up on the platform for Chloe, but she's doing really well. We're just going to come around the communion. We've got our communion pots. We're just going to take a time of reflection, so I just want you to hold it at a moment, then you can open it while the songs are being played. So let's just take a time of reflection and examine ourselves. Father, we think about ourselves and we think, Lord Jesus, what you mean to us, Lord. Time that you died upon the cross, Lord, and rose again. And we thank you, Lord, that you are with us wherever we are. Amen. The worship, you're going to play some songs of worship and you can take your communion as you wish.
Power of sin.
this Mothering Sunday, do you believe the King of Glory makes the orphan a son and daughter? Doesn't matter whether you're a mother this morning, whether you're male or female, you've got a place in the kingdom of God this morning. You are a chosen generation. Can we stand to sing this next song? I am who you say I am. And let's sing it as a declaration over your life this morning. You have a destiny. Your destiny is in Christ. We are seated in heavenly places this morning. Regardless of your status, you are a child of God. And you were predestined before you were born. Amen.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord, that we are your children. Lord, Lord, it doesn't matter how old or how young we are. It doesn't matter, Lord. You know, if we're a man or woman, we're your children and we're welcomed into your house. So thank you, Lord. Thank you for that amazing song and thank you for just loving us so much. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. Well, right. I'm hoping nobody's nicked my chocolates up here and they haven't. So that's good. Right, I'm going to do a little mini quiz. And it's a quiz. It was going to be just for the children, but actually the first question I thought might be a bit tricky. So I'm going to open it up to the adults so you know you've got a chance of winning a chocolate. So, yeah, ooh, I can hear some excited. Right then, I hope you were all watching and listening because the first question is about the video that we played. What was the name of the sacrificial mother from the Bible in the video? Now, this is tricky, not only because you need to know the name, but Eve and I were discussing how on earth we can pronounce the name. So, we've got a young man here. Let's ask you.
Jochebana.
That's brilliant, that's close. Jochebed, brilliant! Definitely deserve a chocolate. Fantastic, my goodness. Adults, I'm afraid you missed out there. You were too slow, I thought there'd be adult hands up. Right, next question. Okay, here we go. Who was Jochebed's son? Do I need to say any more? Who led the Israelites out of Egypt? Oh, I'm going to give you a chocolate, but I'm going to ask, who was Jochebed's son who led the Israelites out of it? Oh, we've got another young man. Here we go. He's over here. Here we go. Oh, he's shouting it. Now, what was Jochebed's son?
I don't know. Jochebed, Moses.
Super duper good listening. Right, we're doing well, my goodness. You know your Bible, people. Let's have a look. Now then, these are great people to know. Right, I've got another question. Now, this is a bit tricky. We haven't even covered this morning, so you just have to know this story. What was Moses put into when he was a baby to keep him safe when he was put in the river? We've got a lot of hands. I'm going to go over here.
A basket.
A basket, that's right. Super duper. That's right, Moses was put, fantastic, well done. Now, let me see. Ooh, we're getting going now. I hope I've got another question. I'm going to have to make one up if not. Right. This is the last one, so I expect everybody's hand to be up on this one. What was the name? And it's an easy one. I've forgotten the question. What was the name of Jesus's mum? Oh, it's an easy one, this one. It's an easy one. I'm going to ask, oh dear, it's tricky. I'm going to ask Poppy.
Mary.
Mary, yes. Well done. Right, I'm going to leave the chocolates there. So at the end, all the children can come and have a chocolate anyway, because you are fantastic. Wow, well done. Give yourselves a round of applause. Fantastic. Well, we've mentioned Jochebed, or however you say her name, Jochebed. And she was the sacrificial mum from the Bible mentioned in our video clip. And it's because she gave up her son, Moses, who eventually, with God's help, helped the Israelites to find freedom. I'm a bit out of breath now. And, you know, there's been a lot on the news about the people from Ukraine. And Jochebed really made me think of some of the Ukrainian mums and families, really, who are acting sacrificially as their sons and husbands and fathers and grandfathers stay and fighting this war for freedom. And one evening, near the beginning of this war, I was almost overwhelmed, really. As I watched the television, I saw a story that was a good news story, not a bad news story, and it was about all this that was going on. In Berlin, in a train station, it showed a picture of all these German families, and they'd gone to the station, and they were holding up cardboard placards, and it said, four people, or two people, or one person. And I thought, what on earth are they, you know, what are they doing there? And actually, it came about that they'd heard that these women and children mainly from the Ukraine were coming on trains and they were going to end up in Berlin. I don't know why, but for some reason they were going to end up there. And these people had heard that this was going to happen, so they went to the train station willing to offer up their homes to these women and children who were coming, who would have, you know, nowhere to stay. And I just felt really, you know, overwhelmed by it, because I thought, wow, you know, these people, they're making a sacrifice. They've seen what's going on, and they've been moved. And I'm sure not all of them are Christians, but, you know, there's hope with Jesus, isn't there? There's a great hope. And so it was just so wonderful. And it said on the news report that all these women and children that came from the Ukraine, all of them had a place to stay when they got to Berlin, because so many people had come out to offer them homes. And I thought, wow, that's how we should be, isn't it? Not necessarily just offering up our homes, but that's how we should be, the hands and feet of Jesus, ready to do whatever needs to be done for people who are in need. So it doesn't necessarily just mean these refugees from the Ukraine, but also people around us, our neighbours. We just need to be ready to show love to them. And it just really, really touched me. I just want to ask Pauline to come up, because she also did something to help towards these people who are in trouble at the moment from the Ukraine. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Myself and Ron have been in the shop in... two shops now, actually, in Merrill Street in Newcastle, volunteering our help. And it's just been truly astounding, the generosity and kindness of people that have donated. And thanks to anyone here who's donated as well. We've filled our car up and taken it down from here. And I know Pastor Jim and Pastor Praveen have taken stuff down as well. But I can't tell you how much it's been appreciated. They've now also been allocated a church hall from the Mormon Church, which is up the Brampton. So all the boxes that we're packing are now being stored up there. And I know a few vans and SUVs have been packed up, and volunteer drivers have taken them, driven them over, and even left them there and flown back. So they've actually left them the transport. And yesterday they were waiting for an Arctic to come, and we were packing up a van which came three times from the shop up to the church hall where the donations are now being stored. But we went in one day, and it's like a little kitchen area at the back of the shop, and it was just full from ceiling to floor with bags of clothes. And the floor space in the shop, there wasn't any. It was just where you could stand to fill a box with everything that you can think of, from toiletries, ladies' feminine wear, nappies, baby formula, flasks, batteries, torches, and we must remember those that are up at the front. I mean, we've been packing boxes for them, which have included razors and shower gel and instant oats, pot noodles and cuppa soups, anything that they've been able to put water to, protein bars and sweets, which have all been boxed up for the soldiers. And also this last week we had four boxes, and I mean huge boxes, of shoe boxes that scout groups have been making up for children. And it just breaks your heart. It really does. Because we opened one, and the things that were in it, and the little note that had been put in with it, it was so touching. You know, you can imagine. So that's something else that they've done. And then this last few days, they've been asking for donations of wheelchairs and walking aids, crutches, walking sticks for the injured soldiers who've lost limbs. So it's not only thinking, you know, of these poor people who've fled their country, you know, to safety, that are living in shelters with all that they've got in bags that they can carry. And going back to the story of the walking sticks, we were just talking about it, and in walked a lady with a carrier bag full of walking sticks. How amazing was that? You know, it was like coincidence, I don't know. But all these folding walking sticks, you know, elderly people coming in and saying, well, I don't know what to do, I don't know what to get. So I'll make a monetary gift. And they've opened the wallets and the purses, and they've given £100 at a time. It's just truly, it's overwhelming, actually. But I praise God, you know, for all the help, for all the volunteers, for everyone involved that's helped with these, you know, for these poor people. Thank you.
Thank you, Pauline. That's amazing to hear, isn't it? I just want to ask Roy to come up as well now, please, because I think the young people are going to be doing something special as well to help.
Thank you. If there's any young people in from the youth group, can you just come up here 1 minute, please? Come on, guys. And I'm not. Don't let them sit in their seats. Poke them in the ribs. Make them get up. Did I say that out loud? Sorry. Come on, folks. All you young guys. Don't let any of them stay comfortable. Come on. There's only a few of them. Come on, there's more than usually. Right, some of them might not be here today. But we've been learning very much in the last couple of months in the youth. We've been studying all about God's love and how God expects us to love him. And he also expects us to love one another. And we've really, really been thinking about this. And we looked particularly at how Jesus was willing to do things like wash the disciples' feet. You know, not exactly a task that anybody would relish. And we thought, what can we do to make a bit of an impact as a youth? What can our young guys do where we can all get involved? To help, we can see this massive problem out in Ukraine where they've got loads of issues, loads of problems from people being displaced to not having food and water and so on. So we thought what we can do is try and do something where we make a difference here, but we also make a difference in Ukraine. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a sponsored litter pick. So these guys aren't really excited about doing the litter pick yet. I've got some motivating to do yet to get them there. But that's what we're going to do. And there's a lot more of them as well who just don't happen to be here today. But that's what we're going to do. We're going to do a sponsored litter pick. And the money that we raise through our sponsors, we're going to send to a charity called Chrysalis, which is a UK-based charity, and what they do is they work with trusted contacts in Romania and Moldova, which is a couple of the countries where many of the Ukrainian people are being displaced to. And what we're going to do, they will buy things like mattresses and food and stuff that goes directly into the church. A lot of the people are being housed in church halls and things like that. You know. So it'll be getting mattresses for them. It'll be getting practical stuff, but getting it locally. So that's what we're going to do. We're not going to start doing our sponsorship thing until next week because it took me a bit longer to get all of the bags and things from Newcastle Council and permission and stuff. But that's what we're planning on doing over the coming weeks. So you'll probably hear more about it in the weeks to come. So thank you, everyone.
Well, thank you, Roy and the youth. Lovely. And thank you, Pauline, as well. That's wonderful. I just want to read again Romans 12, verses 9 to 13, because it just fits perfectly with what Roy was saying. Your love must be real. Hate what is evil, hold on to what is good. Love each other like brothers and sisters. Give your brothers and sisters more honour than you want for yourselves. Do not be lazy, but work hard. Serve the Lord with all your heart. Be joyful because you have hope. Be patient when trouble comes and pray at all times. Share with God's people who need help. Bring strangers in need into your homes. I thought that just, you know, fit perfectly. And also, just to finish with, I just want to mention Mary, who we had on the video as well, who is the mum of the saviour of the world, our saviour. And we just, it's wonderful. Jesus is why we're here today. And it was really, he brought us into God's family. God sacrificed his son for you and for me. And I want to read from 1 John 3, verse 1. It says, "See what kind of love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are." And in some versions it says, "where God has lavished his love on us." So feel lavished in love today, because God is lavishing that love on you. And if you don't know Jesus as your Saviour, and if you don't know God as your Father, please don't leave here today without talking to somebody, because it's so important. You're missing out on so much on life. God gives us life and God gives us hope. And you wonder why we're speaking about things about the Ukraine and we're able to have hope, you know. Well, it's because of Jesus, that's why. So if you don't know him, please don't leave here today without speaking to somebody. And just know that you're lavished in love, whoever you are. I think we're going to have a Big Fish video now, which is just a short clip, but it's got some Mother's Day pictures, okay, that I hope you feel blessed by. Blessing, which Atiemi is going to play. So if you can, please stand, and we'll have the offering at the same time, please, as well.
Please.
Ian is going to close in prayer for us.
Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for our time this morning. We thank you for the message about how we're all loved by you and we're all part of your family. And I pray as we go out into our week that we take that love with us and share it with those around us. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a blessed week this week and hope you have a great day today as well. Thank you.